Ladies and gentlemen, acknowledging the economic devastation that has been caused by the response to the coronavirus outbreak, the Pope today signaled that this actually is a huge opportunity, a great chance for us all to reinvest in a new economy that is a green one and one that is more equitable and less capitalistic. Francis denounced the perverse economic model that allowed the wealthy to exploit the poor and turn the earth into an immense pile of filth. Well, this is not entirely new rhetoric coming from the Pope, but it's important to call this out because this is cover fire for what's actually going on at the state and local levels and around the world, and that is that people are doing exactly that. Governor Inslee, who is a slime ball, if you will allow me to say so, and who you may remember from a very recent report on this, the Ice Age Farmer broadcast, is forcing small producers to let their crops rot in the fields, including apples, his state's most profitable crop. Doesn't matter. We're just going to tear this state apart. That's what he does. It was also he who last week announced that people who don't comply with the orders to field all their information to contact tracers, to give their IDs to restaurants as they reopen, right? All of these totalitarian measures for complete data collection and complete violation of any privacy. He says, if you're not willing to give us the answers, if you're not willing to take our coronavirus tests, and what that means is soon, if you're not willing to take our vaccines, then we will literally not allow you out of your house. In his words, quote, we will attach to these families a support person who will check in to see what they need on a daily basis. And if they can't get someone else to do their grocery shopping, the state will be there to provide for them. Or translated, therefore, those individuals that refuse to cooperate with the contact tracers, or refuse testing, or refuse vaccines, those individuals will not be allowed to leave their homes to purchase basic necessities such as groceries or prescriptions. So, A, this is a completely ridiculous thing to hear from a governor. I mean, this can only be a sign that the second wave, or pandemic 2, as Bill Gates is now openly calling it, coming, is on its way, and it will merit this kind of a response. It's not until we actually hit that second wave that this kind of a thing doesn't just seem completely insane. So that tells us that the second wave is going to be significant enough to warrant this kind of discussion. But it also is also a indication that the state is completely willing to use food as a weapon. This is also not a surprise to us, but it's the first time that he says, look, I'm not going to let you go get groceries unless you give me your information. You're not going to go out to eat at a restaurant unless you hand over your driver's license to them, and they're compelled to give it to me just so that they can reopen their business. So he's openly threatening you with starvation and with force and with economic siege at the restaurant level to comply with these totalitarian measures that they're taking. But that's not all. This week, true to the Pope's cover fire that he's providing, everybody needs to rebuild the green economy, Inslee announced a 1.5 trillion, with a T, green stimulus plan around the coronavirus. And they're just conflating these two things, hoping you don't notice. It's called a stimulus plan because we need to survive this economic depression that we're in now. But no, it's actually the Green New Deal wrapped up in a new packaging here and called a stimulus bill, because everyone wants to pass a stimulus bill, especially if we're all hurting in the worst economic depression in American history. And that's where we are now. People don't appreciate that yet, but we need to know our backs are up against the wall, and he's now creating this plan, which is only going to give incentives to people who toe the party line on climate change. And in their own words, we need to jumpstart our economy, and we need to get it moving in the right direction, that direction being away from fossil fuels.
This has always been an economic opportunity, but it is such a no-brainer at this moment with the COVID crisis that has precipitated this enormous economic challenge. And we should not miss an opportunity to understand the economic necessity of this. And we should not be intimidated when people say, oh, you can't use this COVID crisis, you know, to peddle a solution to climate change. No, we have to recognize the necessity of this moment that this will allow us to rebuild our economy and jumpstart it. It was a necessity before the COVID crisis. It is an absolute requirement now to rebuild our economy. And we shouldn't be intimidated by Republicans about this.
This kind of economic withholding from certain parts of the economy and only giving funding, only giving stimulus to the parts of the economy that meet their agenda and that serve to further enslave the population is also not new. In fact, the EU, the ECB, the European Central Bank, announced openly, again, this is last year, announced this year in February, announcing that, but also Lagarde has been talking about this for a couple years now, the ECB, European Central Bank, must make climate a central pillar of its economic policy, of its financial motivations. European lawmakers have endorsed a parliamentary resolution calling on the ECB to assess how can the bank help our climate policies, aiming to put bond purchases and support from the ECB, again, towards green policies and away from petrochemical economy. 61% of these corporate bond purchases take place in sectors that are responsible for the greenhouse gas emissions. We can't be financing this with a clean conscience, says Lagarde. We got to take the money away from these people now that we've made them completely dependent on these stimuluses.
Yep.
And so this is what Inslee is implementing in Washington with his $1.5 trillion coronavirus stimulus plan. We're only going to give money to the people that toe the party line. It's just like the social credit score. If you don't do your contact tracing, then we're not going to let you go out to eat. We're not going to let you get groceries. This is the same thing, but applied at a much larger and financial level. If you don't make a green business, and if you're not eating crickets out of a robotic insect farm, then we're not going to give you funds. So that's what's going on here. And I just want to remember that this is truly the wolves removing their sheep's masks,
yes,
and showing themselves to be what they really are.
Yes, 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 and yes. This is why they used the mask. This is why we've done videos talking very early on, trying to get a rendering and understanding of what was surrounding us, what was happening, dividing surgically between the false narrative and going, relying heavily upon the words of Christ to give us direction, the deception that the God makers, the false God makers, they believe themselves to be gods and they will acquire technological advances with their witchcraft as well to put some type of mark inside their flesh, inside their temple, to as like a fake Holy Spirit, a substitute, a false spirit, an electronic something that yokes technology, AI, robotics, etc., internet, etc., together into their flesh. And these are the people that Christ specifically pointed his finger at in excuse me, the Olivet Discourse, portions of Luke 21, very early on in that text, and also matching and agreeing with information early on in Mark 13, which all tells us that the sign of the end, so the end has a beginning, the preliminary setup of coming, as these people, the God makers, the liars, the people that believe the delusion, are setting up the lie of this CV, blah, 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 whatever, spiky ball syndrome, the lie, so that they can bring about their goals as they organize and implement portions of this beast kingdom in anticipation of their coming dictator. And this is all about a green agenda, as he's dictating to you. There is a reason why they are using the mask. There's a reason why the symbology is so prevalent in the masked deception. There's a reason why, and we've talked about this, we've done videos. Just please tour the channel because there's a ton of videos on here. And each video is a little piece of the mosaic to put together an understanding of what's going on how quickly these things are advancing, what players are involved in this. And so Kanye has for years used this teddy bear or this teddy bear suit. And it looks all sweet and soft and cuddly on the outside, right? But deep down inside, these are ravenous wolves. And Christ warned you about these people in multiple places in the Bible. And then, of course, we have the commentary from the Holy Spirit working through the last surviving apostle who was not martyred, John, to give us the revelation. And we just bound all those things up, this concert of all this scripture. And when you read the Greek, you are given layers and layers and layers of information that so far extends out, giving you more of like a 360 understanding, layer by layer in the Greek, as opposed to just merely the English, which is a transliteration copy of the Bible in your language. And so when you really get into Bible Hub and you take the effort to go through each and every word, and each and every word sometimes have more root words and more cousin words, as I like to call them. And there can be, you know, just a ton of information, just to keep it simple. These things all start to lend together this idea of us being taken over by these God makers, by these deceivers and liars. And much more could be said about that. And we pepper in a lot of Bible study into our videos as well, to give understanding and to show the continuity and relationship between what God has said in His Word and what you actually see developing with your leadership around you. And they are communists. Yes, they are green communists, really. And we have talked about the implementation of Agenda 21. You should understand that the Pope is a communist from South America. Yes. And so it makes good sense that they have supplied you this deception. All of the media are working together to cause people to believe that this is a real thing, so that in the end, their whole problem, reaction, their solution can be ramrodded through by your dictators. And these are the New Agers. These are the thousand points of light. These are the Masons. These are the people that worship spirits, and they've been placed in all positions of power and authority. And so this is the setup that Christ told you, the preliminary setup for a coming line in the sand, definitive, and now, day one, coming on a Feast of Trumpets that we've talked about so many times on this channel. That is day one of Jacob's time of trouble, and they are setting up for it now. And we were instructed to not be terrified, to not be troubled as they put forth this commotion, these wars, these rumors of wars, and overall just this whole entire deception. That really, it's interesting because until it actually happens, you don't really get the full flavor of what Christ was warning about. So there's always that weird little union of, well, not even union, more of a contrast between theory and then actual experience. So as Christ, you know, we have been reading in the scriptures forever, and we'll go back to this video in just a moment here, but when Christ is answering his disciples and saying, what shall be the sign of your coming, you know, and the end of the age and so on and so forth. And remember, the end has a beginning, a middle, and an end. And in order to have a tribulation, you got to have day one of 7 years, and you got to have an end cap, an end day to the 7 year tribulation. And those all correlate to feasts. Feast of Trumpets starts it. Feast of Atonement finishes it. So anyhow, you're creeping towards that. And Christ had warned us about this deception. And you can read it in scripture, 5 million, trillion, bajillion, those are numbers, times, but until you actually start experiencing it and looking around and comparing this with the Greek and understanding, and then, you know, then you can understand fully what Jesus and appreciate fully what Jesus was trying to warn you about. Oh, yes, that deception, the deception that has arrested the world's economy as they, you know, everything that we've already talked about, as they change everything, as they keep you away from church, as they dictate what you will and won't do. And so they are using, okay, so everybody keeps quoting the whole, you know, let no good crisis go unwasted. True. But that almost gives the sense and feeling like, oh, well, this thing just kind of sort of happened one day and now they're using it to their benefit. You have to understand, they're the ones that created the situation that they're taking advantage of, because this is how they do it. This is how they work. They create the deception so they can ramrod through their agenda. And that is what you see elapsing all around you with these satanic individuals. And Christ called them the kings of the earth. And so it's interesting. If you checked out my videos yesterday discussing old humanity that is parlaying itself into this new humanity through this crisis, which is Babylon, evil humanity gone to pot, and copying the new creation in Christ, God's plan. Then we talked about, when you look at that green, that word for the pale, chloros or whatever it is in the Greek, and you start investigating what was that pale horse, that green, sickly, pale horse, you find out that that actually has tiebacks to Demeter, the goddess Demeter of like harvest and fertility and stuff like that. And as you keep studying that, you find out, oh, Gaia. This is about Gaia. So in other words, what I'm saying is the fourth seal that they put forth, where they actually introduce pestilence. Jesus tells us that piece of the puzzle, famines and earthquakes and pestilence. That's disease, which he said that would happen. That would be them. And John agrees with this as he's talking about this pale, sickly horse, this personification of a scenario utilizing whatever it is exactly that the evil human beings that worship devils and hate you and value Mother Earth, so to speak. I don't call it that, but they do. Over human life, the depopulation agenda, and so on and so forth, you find out that this has everything in the world to do with just that, this Mother Earth character, this Gaia entity. And these people literally believe that the earth is possessed of a spirit, that the earth is a real living thing. And while I would say, you know, yes, the earth is a living thing and that plants and vegetation and stuff like that grow on it, it's not its own entity. It is not imbued or whatever with a spirit. But see, that's what they think. And then one of these days, they're actually going to give it a voice. And guess who it's going to be pretending? It's going to be Lucifer as an AI abomination of desolation, Mother Earth, that they're going to give rise to. This queen bee, this whole bee theme that you're seeing everywhere, and Paula White dancing around like a fool on stage in her pulpit doing her bee dance. Absolute fool. These people are gnar. These people are evil. These people are fake. These people are not real Christians. These people are Masons. It's this 1,000 points of light. And all of this is, you know, getting them on one page for this coming depopulation, for their worship of what they would call Mother Earth, Gaia. And so, you know, they want to introduce pestilence into the planet, as well as many other things, the destruction of the food supply, the using the food as a weapon, which he just articulated, especially our dictator here in Washington. And so these things are building and coming, these threats. You know, they won't remain threats for long, they'll be put into action. But I don't think they can do what they want to do until Christ comes in Revelation 10 and says, and time shall be no more. Let's do this. Let's see this final 7 years, and he removes his bride. But there's lots of people that are not actually born again, that just banty about with that label that they're a Christian. All of those people and all the unbelievers, all the people of various religions that reject Jesus and deny his name, refuse to be born again, are all collectively being set up for this coming beast kingdom where they inject pestilence into on purpose. They really need people to believe. We talked about this. They need people to believe that this is a real threat, so that later when you give your arm over, they really can create the scenario by directly injecting you with whatever sorts of toxins they want to, and whatever sort of disease and pestilence and whatever that really will take human life. And by the fourth seal, with the combination of all four of the seals, the Antichrist, war, you've got all these Islamic jihadis over here that, you know, have camps, they're training for, you know, becoming better murderers. We know they're here in America. We know that they are embroiled all throughout society. Many of us have wondered, why the heck does the government allow it? Because they're all on the same page. All the bad guys are uniting to destroy as much humanity as possible, and really with a goal of a certain subsect of their hatred, the church, the replacements, the sons of God. Well, if you know your Bible, then you know back in Genesis 6, portions of Zechariah early on in that text, and Job 38, the angels are called the sons of God too. Yes, it's there. Look it up. Job 38. We're replacing them. They're going to be demoted, these fallen angels. That's one of the reasons they hate you so much, if you bear the name of Christ. Anyhow, so this is where all this stuff is going. And so they have manufactured this lie for so many reasons, to take advantage, to change things, to appropriate their will to the goddess lie of Mother Earth, that, you know, you, a bunch of you, 2 billion of you, they're setting up for the deaths of 2 billion people. 2 billion of you need to die so that we can preserve Mother Earth. That is their sincerely held religious beliefs. Well, that sounds bat crap crazy to us. I'm sorry, I like that word, crap. Well, that sounds crazy to us. You have to realize that's what these people sincerely believe. That they're as serious about their religion as born-again Christians are about our God and what he's doing with us. And this is where you see the spiritual battle forming. Yes, it comes from the top, as far as Lucifer, the spirits, the principalities and powers and rulers and high places and so on and so forth that Paul warned us. But see, they have a communal relationship with these various leaders on earth. And this is all a concocted, massive, pussy, disgusting, conflated, cancerous lie. And what's holding it all together are the big giant liars through what I like to refer to as the devil box, the television or whatever device you watch TV on. And they continue to push this idea that all of these hospitals are just overrun. All of these mortuaries are overrun with dead bodies. And then you've got people on YouTube that will drive their bike through New York to the hospitals and the funeral homes and show you there's nothing happening. Plus, you can also attest to these things. We live very near to a funeral home and drive past it occasionally to go buy groceries or whatever. There is no more activity at the hospitals and the funeral homes that you can witness. I witness with your own eyes and your own ears, to counter the lies that they're telling you through the devil box. But see, they don't want you to use your own eyes and ears, because you were in the middle of a 1984 type of scenario where they tell you the reality. You might go, who has all that energy to keep up those lies? Well, see, this is what we're saying. It's because at the end goal, what your Lord warns you would happen, this murder of 2 billion people. That's a lot of people. That is a lot of people. Have you thought about that? Is it just static words on a page when you do your minute Bible study or whatever? Which, I mean, I'm not saying you per se, I'm just saying in general. I hate those minute Bible studies. You get a lot out of 60 seconds. Go read the Bible for like an hour and absorb it. I'm not saying to my listeners per se, I'm just making a blanket statement out to people. But anyhow, you know, it is their sincerely held belief that they need to dispose of you. It's part of their holy activity. It is their sacrifice. It is what makes Mother Earth, their spirits that they worship, happy. And so they are setting up and creating the conditions right before injecting pestilence and cutting off the food supply. And I know that the thing that people want to do in their minds is just shut down this horrible thought and go, you know what, I can't handle this. This is not happening. This is not real. I need to turn away from this. I need to just not engage in this thought. But they're still doing it, whether you want to be aware of it or not. And people tend to have this sense of denying the truth for self-preservation, or, you know, you've been taught the identity that the American is, you know, America is the land of the free and the home of the brave and all that stuff, this identity that they've given to you, which helps to kind of numb your brain out to what's actually happening. No, our identity is that everything is fine. But that was all part of the narrative way back then. Anyhow, we could say much more, but that's, you have powerful dictators and powerful kings that hate you, leaders, and they are willing, just like he mentioned, Inslee is willing to let the fruit crop in Washington perish. Why? Because they're setting up for the global famine, just for one little pocket of the world. There are many other things being done, and this will all end up playing out into a big, ginormous global famine. Now, of course, it won't touch them because they already knew this was coming because it's part of the plan. So they have their underground bunkers, and they have their food supply, and they have their hyper, whatever they're called, their grow gardens underneath the earth and whatever. There's been reports as well that they have underground prisons and stuff, which I'm not really sure what is underground, but anyhow, much more can be said about that. They're also moving guillotines around that need to be assembled. They are moving them around. Truckers, not a lot of truckers, because they're hosing the trucking industry, but they are moving around guillotines to be placed wherever, and that apparently will also be part of the threat. You get the vaccine or you get your head taken off. And that also fits in with Noah Hyde and many other things. So I mean, these people who are all just sitting here going, oh, this crisis is so bad, we just need to take advantage of this crisis and put through these good measures for a green economy. Really, this is the worst of the worst, the most satanic, the most evil. These will be the reason why people will be able to understand why hell exists for these people, for this filth, this moral rot and degradation that refuses to repent and be made whole in Christ. And they want to take your lives, and they want to starve you out, and they're going to smile watching it for whoever will be here. And they have been working on the end of creating as many false converts as possible for a long, long time. So lots of people for their bloodthirsty desires and tastes to exact that revenge on humanity, or whatever their motivation is. I guess for them, sin is fun. I guess, I don't know. So, you know, that's kind of the backdrop of what's going on. He nails it, the wolves in sheep's clothing. Whoops. And that is exactly what your Lord told you, that outward, oh, they look all sweetie, sweet, sweet, don't they? But inward, Matthew 7, they are ravenous wolves. Ravenous. You almost hear those words so many times that it loses their meaning. It loses its meaning. Ravenous wolves. They are hungry for your destruction. And that this necessitates a life-saving measure for the Lord to come and remove his remnant, Philadelphia. That's right there in scripture for anybody to read it. Take you out, ek, out. The Greek is out, not through. He's not taking you through the tribulation. If you are truly born again, he is taking you out. That's what he said in the Greek. In the letter to Philadelphia in Revelation 3, 7 through 13. And he had words of repent and command to the other fake churches. Lots of fake churches. Lots of fake converts. So anyhow, the mass deception. Well, there's going to come a point where, you know, little by little, bit by bit, moment by moment, they're removing that mask a little bit more so you can see their true identity of the masked deception. And they don't care about you. Anyhow, I want to get back to the Ice Age farmer here.
They are. When you see Governor Inslee saying, yeah, we just destroyed the entire economy, forget our apple crop, not a big deal, but this is a terrific opportunity to make sure that we get climate change. Well, you can tell that, in fact, these two agendas have the entire time been one and the same, perpetrated by the same people, these Fabian socialists, these totalitarian...
Fabian socialists, yes. And remember, socialism often matriculates to its final, more evil form of communism, where they just murder you off.
Transhumanist,
yes.
Chasing technocrats,
yes.
Who are trying to enslave everybody.
Yes.
If Inslee is out there making the case that this is an opportunity for climate change to get a front row seat in all things that are rebuilding the economy, then Governor Cuomo in New York is taking a slightly different tack, going for the gold star of the Screen New Deal, as it's being called, complete panopticon totalitarian surveillance state, as imagined, and it is now being openly implemented by the billionaire technocrats, Eric Schmidt, Bill Gates himself. So here we go. Critics are slamming Cuomo's plan to reimagine the state of New York's schools with the Bill Gates Foundation.
What? This is kind of hard to take. Wow. Okay. Wow. So you can investigate for yourself, although we did videos yesterday going over this, but Melinda Gates is walking around sporting an interview in an upside down cross, which is very much about the visual communication of destroy the church, get her, right? And so now they want to use information from these people to sculpt your children's brains before they steal them.
As The Guardian hears from Business Insider, former Google CEO Eric Schmidt has now left Alphabet completely as he's taking on more government work. He's got super deep connections to the DoD. He's taking on government projects like military technology, AI, and COVID-19 response.
Oh, wow.
Well, there's a nice way of putting dressing on the fact that this guy is now openly taking over the data from everything in the state of New York. I'll get there in a second. From The Guardian, Cuomo is now letting billionaires run New York City and New York State's future. It doesn't have to be this way. From the opinion piece, last week, Cuomo announced that Bill Gates would be responsible for reimagining New York's education system, and that Eric Schmidt, former Alphabet CEO, would be leading a panel planning New York's post-COVID tech infrastructure. Or, again, complete surveillance state being implemented in every...
Complete surveillance state. Did you just drink that in? Do you see how this deception cover story, big giant lie of nothing more than a seasonal rhymes with glue, is being utilized as the cover of night to implement all of these various measures and desires of the devil to have these human beings create the beast kingdom, this technological beast kingdom, surveillance state, born in China, right? You got something from China, but it wasn't no stupid giant seasonal rhymes with glue. We've always had that. They are full-bore communists, and they hate who? Humans in general, but especially the church. especially. And so it is spreading. Is it a coincidence that the Lord uses a flying, satanically sourced, fire-breathing, watchful dragon in Revelation 12? Which not everything in Revelation is in order, and then not every verse is completely in order either. You have vignettes. You have to look at each vignette and then figure out where each verse in each chapter fits in. It's a lot of work and effort. Anyhow, the Lord tried to warn you about this coming surveillance state, and probably much more could be said about that, but now it's forming, and it's like so much change is being put through all at once to overwhelm you. That's all done on purpose to manipulate you and to shut you up so that they just do whatever it is they feel like doing.
Wait, as Naomi Klein described it, as the pandemic shock doctrine, or what I've described as, it's just a bum rush across all vectors of this agenda. Yeah. Everything is pushing forward as quickly as possible. Yes. Things are being implemented that have been prepared for decades, for centuries. Yeah. And it's all rushing forward now while people have been locked at home.
And why is that? Because your Lord warned you that there was a preliminary setup. And he says, but the end, and that's the beginning of the end, not the end of the end, the beginning of the end, is not yet. And when you go look in the Greek, it's very clear. And then there's even another root word. And basically the gist of it, I'm not going to show it to you right this second. Maybe I'll do that another day, or I'll try to remember to stick it in the description box so you can see that for yourself. But the idea is that it's not a straight shot. So in other words, the preliminary is not immediately the beginning of the end. They're going to kind of zigzag, so to speak. They're going to dawdle. They need to set this stuff up first. And that's not immediate. But there is a coming day one that coincides with, they're called the birth pains, that coincide with day one of Jacob's time of trouble. And by the way, Jacob means deceiver, usurper, supplanter, heel grabber, taking that which does not belong to him. And a lot more could be said about that. And the people that are involved in this come from his seed. And then remember, he did have an experience where he learned to trust in the Lord. So that's good. And we say that we worship the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. But there is a reason why back in Bereshit in Genesis that he shows you that Jacob is a deceiver. And then he gets a new name. Do you remember what that new name is in his experience? The new name that is the name of the nation that I can't say, the as above, so below nation that starts with an I, that wrestles with God. So you have the deceiver, usurper, or supplanter who wrestles with God. And that's what this 7 years is about. And what do they want to do? Well, they're wrestling with God for a blessing, but it's not the blessing that God wants to give them as far as being a new creation in Christ. They want to form their own creation. They want to be this new creation in their means of doing it with the technology and the takeover and all this stuff. Some of them will repent. 1/3, Zechariah 13 tells us, but 2/3 will not. And then you have also that added issue of the Gentiles and unbelief. A lot of them will repent too in this final 7 years under draconian measures and just a real nightmare coming. So some will repent, but many will not as well. And so you can see the setup. It's coming. It's huge. And they talk about the Black Mirror show, right? Because they needed to kind of pre-program you or seed you or show you the reality that's coming. That's why they have it in this stupid Netflix program. But yeah, it will be, everything is on this reward slash punishment basis. And remember, these are the people that want to feed the population, not with healthy fruits and vegetables and meat and milk and good things like that. No, that's all going bye-bye as they set up. I think you're 150 days out from the Feast of Trumpets now, today. So what is that, 5 months, I believe? 30 days times 5 months is 150. They want to feed you insects. He's not kidding when he talks about that. This is Agenda 21 slash Agenda 2030. These are horrible human beings, and they want to use the mass surveillance in order to trap you up, make your life a living hell, and destroy 25% of the planet just right off the blocks with much more various parts of their plan to destroy more of humanity. And if Satan had his way, he'd get everyone, which is why Jesus says that all flesh would be destroyed if Jesus didn't come back and say, stop, you know, basically, at the end of the tribulation on the Feast of Atonement.
And don't have time or the brain to respond to it, especially now that they're just trying to make ends meet in a broken economy. So you can see how this is all flowing together. As she points out, these two billionaires have disastrous records in precisely the areas of public policy that they're being tapped to lead. But never mind that. It doesn't matter that they're constant failures. We're going to fail forward. We're going to fail even bigger this time. That's what communism is all about, right? Gates Foundation was doing Common Core. Schmidt has been just a terrible surveillance state envisioned, just gave up on making Toronto his smart city. Schmidt has been pushing the smart cities for a long time, and like I said, working with Toronto to try and implement it there, although he just pulled out of that contract. A more detailed piece of it than The Guardian's opinion piece is here by The Intercept, again, the Screen New Deal. Under this cover of the mass death and this threat of the pandemic, Cuomo is calling in the billionaires to openly plan in front of everyone and implement a new high-tech dystopia. We are ready and we are all in. We are aggressive and ambitious about the changes in front of us. This is what he is saying as he enlists Google CEO Eric Schmidt to come in and take over.
Hold on. You want to see the face of the demon that... Hold on. That's got to be him right there. Yeah, it is him, U.S. Department of Defense. So Google, all the information, the technological information, and add now the U.S. Department of Defense, the military, the information, and the military, marrying it all together with this guy. Doesn't he look all sweet and friendly? Wouldn't you just trust your kids to be near him? He wants you dead. You get that, right? Little smiley face. Hi, I'm Eric, and I want you dead. That's what you should understand. Why does this man have no neck? Yes, big fan of Peter Thiel. You know who that is, don't you? Yeah, we've done videos, by the way, a little side note here, of Palantir data collects everything. Well, the AI stalks you. And then your president gave access to all that stuff to the 45, 50-some Muslim nations that make up EDIDEL, the 24-hour human and AI spy center in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia. We did a video yesterday, released a video yesterday, dealing with the dragon and the threat to the church. If you can kind of understand, in X-Men, they had that, I hate those movies, but they had that Cerebro when it was a scenario of use Cerebro to find all the mutants for what? Destruction. And so the internet, Google, all this technology, this police surveillance state from hell that's being set up, that Cuomo and others are so hell-bent on putting together, the Pope and all these other people with this Green Deal, this Mother Earth-oriented, communistic, pan-neo-communist, paganistic, you know, psychopath, new way of doing everything, and you will comply or you will starve, right? Like that type of attitude, that type of agenda that is slowly but surely the little mask deception, the mask is slipping, and you're starting to see, oh, these people don't really care about us. Yeah, it's all coming together. All of these people, and they know where all the Christians are. That's why you have Palantir. This is why you have Trump going over to Riyadh and his creepidocious, hold on a second, let me find it for you. The glowing orb. What's the problem? See, Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, a mysterious glowing orb is exerting uncanny power over the world's social media. And a lot more could be said about this when this was done. See, this is AI. This is your good friends, the Muslims, who love you, who are working with other nations, and they love you too. Oh, they all love you. They love beheadings, by the way. Oh, you gotta love the New York Times. They're like, you need to pay to be able to access this. Well, you know what? That's fine, because there are other sources. The media just skirted over this, right? They were like, oh, this is like Lord of the Rings. And they didn't really go much into the meat and potatoes of what was happening in this scenario with your dictator, Mason, orange Cheeto, evil bad guy, Kabbalist-oriented, satanic, evil spirit-worshipping bad guy, Donald Trump. And he gave them access to all of our information through their Edadel, which ironically, Edadel means moderate. But see, everything in Satanism gets flipped. Everything does. So this was back in 2017. This is the same year that the Revelation 12 sign returned to me. Shabbat Shuva, read Hosea 14, God's message to the world, I'm coming soon, return to me, right? Same year as Edadel opening. And this was at the time, the crown prince, Solomon, or whatever his name is. Now there's this other younger guy, and he's also untrustworthy. But out of all of these stories, the only thing that they could do was make jokes and make fun of how silly this was in relationship to a stupid movie, as opposed to telling you realize that the Masons and the Islamics just joined together, harvesting over all of your information with AI, stalking you. And they've been doing this for a couple years now. So no wonder Christ uses that image of that communistic red threat dragon. And now they have all this Space Force stuff. I'll have to show you that too. They have a stupid Space Force flag now too. There's so much more that could be said. You know, you start to really think about these people using the surveillance system, this technology against you. You think about Bill Gates, you think about the communists, you think about the Masons, you think about the witches that want to reduce life because that's their value. They value death, not their death, your death. And especially the Christians, the attack on the Christians. And you start to really pay attention to the weird things that are said in Revelation 12, 3 and 4 about this global government taking over. Let me get to the scripture. We'll just do the King James, New King James, I mean, because I like that one too. You really start to think about these verses in light of the technology, in light of the rapid developments with the surveillance state, with your kind, loving communist Mason pagans running the whole deal, right? And another sign appeared in heaven. Behold, a great, that's megalo, that's very, very, very powerful, fiery, red dragon, red blood, fire, having seven heads and 10 horns and 7 crowns on his heads. This is your verbiage for the global government, excuse me. And we're seeing the rise now, the unmasking of the global government. And you can just scroll Agenda 21, the UN, Noahide.org, Universal Noahide. Love from the communists, love from the pagans, all of that. The techie business heads, the people financing this, the military industrial complex, the fourth industrial revolution, all of that tied together is what God is trying to get you to understand by using these phrases and using these symbols and these images. He's trying to get you to understand that what he predicted here is happening. You're there now. You're in the preliminary setup. And so when he says this phrase, just think global government. That's all you need to do. 7 heads, 10 horns, 7 diadems. All the 7 continents. One of these days, pretty soon, they're going to show these 10 heads, these regional 10 directors or, you know, sub-governors over the planet. They're going to chunk up into 10, Club of Rome. And I don't know, something happens to 3 of them, but I don't understand that. And I don't plan on being here to understand that. But this is all you need to understand. The global government has already been revealed. And with this technological power base of Chinese-oriented communism to reward or punish you, is rapidly being deployed. And while Cuomo is one person, you know, who says that you can totally murder your son or daughter up until their birthday, happy birthday, little Timmy, right? These people value death, abortion-minded, horrible individuals. They love their murder. They love to give that blood up to Satan so that he keeps making them millionaires and gives them money. Anyhow, you're here. You are here in verse 3. And then look at what verse 4 says. Look at this. This is really interesting. His tail drew a third of the stars of heaven and threw them to the earth. You know, for years we've tried to understand, what does that mean? The stars of heaven. So a lot of people have wondered, is that like meteorites? Did some kind of a meteorite shower happen? And that's been the prevalent view for a long time in trying to understand this. And I'm not saying that's not the case or that that couldn't happen or that couldn't be part of the puzzle. But I think that it has much more to do with this global government deployment of this technocracy, technology, theocracy from hell being used against you. And I'm really just wondering if we're talking about AI, so stars also has to do with angels, fallen angels. You can't get away from that in scripture. The celestial originating type of technology, you know, drones kind of a thing, something to do with the technology now with the space force that your president has been telling you about as part of the surveillance system. And I'm just wondering if in the next couple months, as we're growing closer to the Feast of Trumpets in 5 months in mid-October, and even, you know, Elul 30 days prior to that, so this would be September. By the way, we don't use paper calendars, and I don't think God uses paper calendars either. We go by stellarium, what's happening in the actual universe lifetime. But anyhow, Because the paper calendars will tell you the Feast of Trumpets is in September, but it's October. Okay. According to Stellarium, it's October is a short story. When the moon is at her feet, and it's only there for a very short period of time, October 17th, and even like a minute after, according to another video I was looking at, not much info out there, a minute after, into the 18th, depending on how literal he is with this whole midnight thing, which he may not be literal on the midnight thing, Matthew 25, that might just be his way of explaining transition, the transition from the end of the age of grace into the church age, the final harvest of Pentecost that started and has an end point. Okay. And then the beginning of the Feast of Trumpets and the beginning of Jacob's time of trouble. And this year is unlike any other year at any point ever in human history. So we pay attention to the admonition in Hebrews 10:25 that you will see the day that no man knows, right? That whole thing, it's a wedding thing. You will see the day approaching. Hebrews 10:25 says that. And Paul agrees with Jesus, and Jesus agrees with Paul. Scripture doesn't war against each other. You just have to understand things from a Hebrew context. Jesus is a Hebrew, not a Gentile, not an American, right? So when Jesus says, no one knows the day or hour, that's the title of the day. It doesn't mean nobody can know. It means you better know. You better be born again and you better know. You better be paying attention. You better be watching for your inheritance. So that said, and we talk about that a lot, one just wonders if there is coming a deployment of verse 4 with regard to the space force that your president has set up. And Bill Gates' piece of the puzzle, the Department of Defense, the Eric Schmidt piece of the puzzle, the technology, Google technology, plus the Department of Defense, this fourth industrial revolution, and this surveillance with live drones that may be equipped with lasers and who knows what else. Flying, fire, breathing, red, bloody, dragon, Chinese. Communism, global. Do you understand what I'm saying? So it will be interesting to see exactly how verse 4 plays out, but we are obviously here in space and time for this particular scripture, and not just the whole chapter, but the individual verse. So we'll be watching for that. Now let me show you the space force flag. I do want to get back to the Ice Age farmer to show the rest of what he has to say, but I can't help but show you this because it's really creepy. And while I did not live this whole video that Pedro did, this part of it I want to show you. It says here, Trump unveils Space Force flag. That's so creepy. And this is from USA Today. This is May 15th. The Pentagon. Says his super duper, what are we, 4-year-olds now? Super duper missiles are hypersonic weapons.
Trump unveils.
Oops, I'm sorry. You gotta love laptops. Hypersonic weapons. What does that mean? And so here's their little flag. Look at his grin. I'm gonna kill me a bunch of Christians, is what he's thinking. He's not a Christian.
Space Force flag. Pentagon says his super duper missiles are hypersonic weapons.
This is the presentation of the Space Force flag. First time in 72 years plus that we've opened up a new branch of the United States military.
Okay, so now they're just mentioning things and maybe things are just playing out. So then yesterday, Trump tweets a spoof video of himself delivering a speech from Independence Day at Area 51, and he included his team and other people and activists who started the Pizzagate theory.
Mankind, that word should have new meaning for all of us today. We can't be consumed by our petty differences anymore. We will be united in our common interests. and you will once again be fighting for our freedom. Not from tyranny, oppression, or persecution, but from annihilation. We're fighting for our right to live.
As pedophiles taking over the planet.
To exist. And should we win the day, the 4th of July will no longer be known as an American holiday, but as the day when the world declared in one voice, we will not go quietly into the night. We will not vanish without a fight. We're going to live on. We're going to survive. Today, we celebrate our Independence Day.
Right, and their Independence Day in this creepidocious thing that Trump and his pedophile friends put together is them saying that they're going to wipe us out, steal your children. We already did videos talking about that. Microchip them, catch them. The church, some of the church is going to help. What? Yeah, some of the church is going to help, because not everything that pastes a tag on its chest that says I'm the church is really truly born again. And they're going to survive. And then when you start to consider that, well, Christ said that wormwood would be coming, right? And John sees something that he says looks like a mountain that lands, hits the water, and poisons the water. And then like another third of the planet, I think the stats were, dies. That's huge. So that's got to be incoming. I don't remember what number of judgment that is, because there's 21 of them. I don't remember which one that is. But, you know, there's a reason why they want to hide under the ground, both to hide from the pestilence that they're going to create. And then also, you know, whatever wormwood is that's coming. But anyhow, this is weird. This is what your president's doing with his free time. Yay.
See the slow buildup of their programming. I feel at this time they are desperate to keep their followers in check. But then I'm hearing about this winter storm operation coming in 2020, so I had to somehow tie this all together, because with this video I'm about to show you guys, very well shows what this could really mean, and is there a way out? So without further ado, here.
And I didn't really like the rest of the video, and I couldn't quite get through the whole thing. But anyhow, so that's weird. That's just weird. And you know, the fact that they're reflagging back out to you the whole Pizzagate thing, which A Call for an Uprising did. I don't know if I want to go to that video right now. I think I'll just tell you about it so we can get back to Ice Age Farmer. But anyhow, you know, they're bringing the whole Pizzagate thing up again, like, oh, they're being mean to that poor Alephantis guy, which apparently is French for like child lover or something like that. Wow. James Alephantis. And I can't even remember what the name. Oh, Comet Pizza, right? Wasn't that what it was called? Comet Pizza. So anyhow, there's a reason why they're reflagging all this back out to you again, reopening the wound, so to speak. And we did a video yesterday of the Pope and Netanyahu and all of these other little pieces of the puzzle for these laws that they want to enact to microchip your children, to get your children. So all these concepts fly together, the technology, the takeover, the communism, all the stuff that we've already talked about, and how God is trying to get you to understand that this global government is here. It's here now. He wants you to perceive this. He wants you to understand the deception and what is happening underneath the deception. And people have been kept away from the book of Revelation because their churches are not teaching them. So they don't really know how to put these things together. But anyhow, when you consider Bill Gates' role. Hold on a second. Let me show you something really quick here. Yeah, here in this video, Revelation 12, Global Government Surveillance, HAP, Dragon, Eye in the Sky, and Stars equal Drones and Spy Satellites. This is a really good video dealing with the technology end of things and what is building and how... See, it all seems to keep coming back to this guy, this Jay guy that is a billionaire. And if you watch this, it actually shows you this creepidocious flying, huge, weird plane thingy that straps... Yeah. How do I want to put this? Here. Bill Gates backs $1 billion plan to cover the Earth in video surveillance satellites. Are the stars that the dragon's tail sweeps to the Earth really just the Holy Spirit and John's way of trying to help you understand the technological point of this global government yikers surveillance, all seeing eye in the sky control system that Camera Rose's channel did? So they want to have these everywhere, and then like laser-equipped drones and stuff like that, and they want to be able to have the whole world wired up. Remember the Internet of Things? Remember that? Where everything is monitored. Everything. And then you can also listen to that song, Sound of Silence, and watch that about 400 times and start to understand the whole point of that, this new humanity that they're building, this new technological trap in this global government. This stuff all goes together. Okay, back to the Ice Age farmer.
Planning the Green New Deal, far more high tech. This is going to...
Sorry about that. Okay, so look at this. Humans are biohazards. Machines are not. Excuse you? See, remember, they want to bring in the AI to take your jobs. They want to do the universal basic income, even though your government, by the way, are dragging their feet on this second stimulus check. They're like, well, let's just wait and see because not everybody's gotten the first one. So they're kind of like messing with you big time. And it's just totally normal that the government wants to give away free money anyhow. But see, we've talked about this in many other videos, how they're printing all this worthless paper dollars. And, you know, when the money is gone, then you're a slave. They're setting all this stuff up. It's coming. He says, it's a future in which our homes... Drink this in, the Gray State trailer. Just drink it in. Drink it in. Are never again exclusively personal spaces, but are also via high-speed digital connectivity, our schools, our doctor's offices, our gyms, and if determined by the state, our jails. Of course, for many of us, those same homes were already turning into our never-off workplaces and our primary entertainment venues before the lie and the surveillance incarceration. Just those two words, surveillance incarceration. And the community was already booming. In the future, under hasty construction, all of these trends are poised for warp speed acceleration. And then you tie that into whatever percentage of the population is going to be forced through this warp speed acceleration of, you know, getting your shot. And I theorize that some people will immediately be just murdered off because that's what scripture says. That's not everybody though. So there must logically be another shot that is to track you like a little kitten. See what I'm saying?
Hospitals with doctor's offices, with restaurants, with everything, collecting data, and from within your house as well, right? So it's a few.
And, you know, when they collect all this data, and they have been for a long time with Edadel, but see, now the Department of Defense, who, by the way, hates you, and the National Security Administration, who, by the way, from Obama's administration, even now, hates you and has categorized the Christian, as the terrorists, not the Muslims who cut people's heads off. No, they're not terrorists, they would tell you. It's the Christian, because this is a satanic organization, source organization of spirits and humans working together to not go after the true enemy, no, to go after the Christian, which is why in Revelation 12:5, when this dragon is poised, so that must be coming. Look, and the dragon stood before the woman who was ready to give birth. Why is there a woman giving birth? Because Jerusalem is a personification of a covenant, the death, burial, resurrection, and Pentecost, indwelling of the Holy Spirit, the gospel, that produces what? The one new mankind in Christ. Christ the head, the church the body, you are the forever humanity. The new creation, sons of God, family of Christ, take over and take precedence over the old creation. And the old creation is going to take a fire bath when everything's said and done. Vessels of wrath versus the vessels of grace. Well, the vessels of grace have this global government, technological, spirit, human, AI enhanced, fallen angel thing, conglomerate, engine after you. Do you understand that? You're being set up. So the woman was ready to give birth. Give birth, why? Your glorification. You're going to take on new flesh. This is exactly what Paul explains to us in Galatians 3 and 4, that the church never seems to, the church leaders never seem to feed to the church, the parishioners, to connect Galatians 3 and 4, Isaiah 54, 1, Revelation 12, Isaiah 66, all of these verses together, Romans 8, the redemption of your flesh, they all go together. You're going to be born in that you get new flesh. You're the heir. Sarah had her heir, Isaac. Now Jerusalem is going to have her heir, the one new mankind in Christ. So the dragon stood before the woman, Jerusalem, who was ready to give God's new creation their glorified flesh, so as to devour her, the one new mankind in Christ, the child, the heir, as soon as it was born, the many within the one. So it will be interesting to see in the months as the preliminary is setting up, and a lot can be done in a short period of time, especially with enough hands and everybody's out of your way, trapped up in their houses and so on and so forth. But then something happens. There's a game changer. We're waiting for the game changer. This coincides with the Feast of Trumpets. She bore a male child who is to rule all nations with a rod of iron. The head and the body together, the one new mankind. And look at this. And her child was caught up. That's the harpazo. That's the rapture. That's the glorification and the exit. That's the wedding. That's the going and hiding in the chamber until God's indignation passes, Isaiah 26. This is the calling up of the dead and the raising of the living to get your new flesh, 1 Thessalonians 4:16 and 1 Corinthians 15. The rescue. There's a rescue coming. When? The day and hour no man knows. i.e. Feast of Trumpets, your wedding day, your birthday, caught up to where? To God and his throne. Verse 6, whoops, that's going to go to the other chapter, which I don't want. Verse 6 is going to start talking about what happens to Israel, to the people who did not get born again, but God still has an election for them. Talking about two completely different entities. Everybody seems to just meld that all together. Verse 5 is talking about someone completely different than it's talking about in verse 6. You have to look at each verse. Anyhow, so we appear to be here in verse 3. We should know more in verse 4. And I really just wonder if there's a deployment of these drones where you start to realize, oh, the communists mean business. Like, you're kind of starting to get that sense from Cuomo. Get back here. So anyhow, you're just kind of starting to get that realization as the mask is lowered more and more and more. Oh, you're not the nice, sweet people running the thing that we thought that you cared about us and loved us. You're really just diabolical, communist, Masonic, evil. Right. And that's, as we get closer, the mask is going to come down more and more, you understand? So even the most dull among us will kind of start to get a clue as they roll it out a little more and a little more each day, right? As you see the day is capped, the day of the Lord, the day of judgment, the Yom Hadin, the day approaching.
Our homes are not personal spaces with privacy anymore. Instead, now they are, because of high-speed digital connectivity, our schools, our doctor's offices, our gyms, and if the state wants it to be this way, they become our jails. Everything's delivered via drone or driverless cars. There's no cash. All of these things have been imagined for a couple years now, but now, under the cover of the pandemic, well, just hire Eric Schmidt, put him in charge of New York State, roll it all out. Let's just get it done. We're aggressive. We're New Yorkers. Can you believe the gall that they have as they just implement these totalitarian technocratic ideas? New York State, quote, is being positioned as the gleaming showroom for this grim future.
For this, quote, grim future. Are you taking this in? What? Grim future. Oh yeah, I didn't catch that. Our jails, not the jails, our jails. Meaning your home is no longer private. It's now your jail.
And at the center of it all is Eric Schmidt, who, well before we even understood the threat of COVID-19, had been aggressively lobbying about the Black Mirror vision of society that Cuomo has now just empowered him to build.
The Cuomo has just empowered him to build. Do you think it will stay central just in New York? Not with the exuberance of Trump to have a space force. They're going to lock this planet down with surveillance. Are you seeing the picture? Are you seeing how it's all coming to fruition? Are you understanding how God, he's so brilliant, how God tried to explain to you in Daniel's dreams back in the book of Daniel in the Old Testament? Israeli News Live would tell you that the Old Testament's done. Daniel says it's still happening. Do you understand the relationship between that book of the Old Testament still being doled out and enacted with the Holy Spirit trying to help John and our generation now understand this technological theocracy from hell while they drain all the wealth of your dollar and then they sit back and play games with people? We don't know if we're going to give you money or not. Oh, you're suffering? Oh, sucks to be you, doesn't it? We might give you more money. We don't know. While they're taking trillions.
At the heart of this vision is a seamless integration of government with Silicon Valley giants, with the schools, hospitals, like I said, all these things, and military that he's now working with the DOD on, all outsourcing to big tech, all of this AI. It's a vision.
Right. Oh my gosh, this is so chilling. So basically, Satan and the AI, the fallen angels, and the wicked human beings who refuse to have their sinful nature basically cut out are all going to have access to raw, unlimited 24/7 power. What do you think they're going to do with it?
Eric Schmidt had been advancing in his roles, ready, as chair of the Defense Innovation Board, which advises the DOD on using AI in the military, and also as chair of the powerful National Security Commission on AI, or NSCAI. Ladies and gentlemen, you may remember, briefly, I just want to mention that the Pentagon just took this program live, where they started requiring retail establishments to give all of their grocery transaction data over to a system that is basically, it is exactly a weapons AI platform for the military. It's called the Joint All Domain Command and Control System. And this is one of the data sets, along with a bunch of other military data, that's now being plugged in. So the JAIC, who's behind this product, is one of the child subgroups of the NSC, the National Security Council on AI, that Eric Schmidt is working with. So this is part of his work. This is a brainchild. And when we see the DOD integrating retail grocery transactions down to the individual customer into their military weapons system, and when we see Cuomo tapping Eric Schmidt to deploy this totalitarian surveillance state across New York, this is him building that empire, building that AI in response, claiming to do it in response to China and Russia doing the same thing.
Oh, did you just take in what he said? Wow, this is hard to take. So this guy doesn't strike me as a believer. He never talks about the Lord Jesus. He never mentions anything about the Bible. I don't think he's saved. I don't think he's going. But he does a really good job of explaining what's going on with the media and the technology, the food and all that kind of stuff. And he just said that other nations, other communist nations, are doing the same thing. You're all being wired up the Internet of Things for your totalitarian prison planet. Tyranny. How the U.S. national security state is using the thing to fulfill an Orwellian vision. They created it, and now the problem, reaction, their solution. They're creating the solution, which isn't a solution at all. It is the beast kingdom coming. It's coming. Last year, a government commission called for the U.S. to adopt an AI-driven mass surveillance system. Oh my word. Far beyond that used in any other country. Now, many of the obstacles cited as preventing its implementation are being removed under the guise of the thing.
And but even if that's true, this is just not the future that we want to walk into, ladies and gentlemen.
This is the future that's coming because God saw it. And he tried to help us through Daniel and John and Jesus' synoptic gospels, warning you and telling you and explaining that there was a day of Noah coming and that there was the necessity to board the ark through that one door. And today Christ is our ark, the ark of the renewed covenant. Okay? The one way in. So that you can exit through the doors, the portal, whatever you want to call it, the gates to heaven, to be protected and not left down here in the flood of judgment, the flood of the debt that's coming, the flood of the prison planet, the flood of you do what we say or else. And it's not even like you get anything good in return. You know, it's like, well, if you get a certain credit score, social score, whatever, while we're monitoring everything in this nightmare, then maybe you'll be able to go to the worm farm and get some worms to eat. Just for an example. But remember, these are the same people smiling, getting ready to put some horrible substance in your arm while your doorknob of a president, I'm sorry, but he's just evil, sits there and asks, can we inject disinfectant into the human body? Can we do that? We need to look into that. Yeah, he's totally telling you.
Gentlemen, we cannot let them deploy this kind of technology.
You can't fight it. You cannot fight it. You just need to get on the ark and get as many other people on the ark as possible. Get the kids on the ark. You can't fight it. God already saw it happen. Just crack open the Bible. Just read it. It's all there.
Technology and gain total information awareness and fire up AIs that are working at anti-human goals. Here from Mint Press News is a little bit more about how the U.S. national security state is using coronavirus to fulfill an Orwellian vision. Last year, a government body dedicated to examining how AI can address national security and defense needs of the U.S., and that is the NSC AI, with whom Eric Schmidt is working, detailed the structural changes that the economy and society must undergo if we're going to have any technological competition with China. In other words, this is the Dr. Strangelovian AI gap. We're worried about a missile gap. We're worried about an AI gap with China. And if they have better data, then they'll be able to outperform our military. And so it's not about nukes now. It's about data. And it's about building AI systems with Eric Schmidt that get all of the data and then can make decisions based on that.
Okay, I also want to say that they have built within your mind the idea that it is nation against nation. I would tell you that that's not correct. I would tell you that it is the cabal, the rich, wealthy Masonic kings of the earth. Just read Psalm 2, against the constituents, the people of their nations. Now, that doesn't mean that there won't come a time when it's nation against nation, kingdom against kingdom in the birthing pains, 7 years of hell. But you also have to understand the operators above that are pulling the strings. Does that make sense? And Jesus alludes to this through the Holy Spirit, through John, when they talk about the third seal, the famine. And that reference to don't hurt the oil and the wine, that's the rich. And then you've got the poor that are starving to death, that, you know, one penny for a measure of wheat or whatever, right? Like a whole day's wage for one meal for one person, right? The starvation factor, that's the poor. So he's trying to tell you that when you read about that third seal. And then just Satan just loves chaos. It's his thing, right? So they're going to promise peace, but deliver hell, right?
And, you know, briefly, while it looks like China and Russia and the U.S. are military at ends with each other, and there's some truth to that, right? China and U.S. very much on a...
That's the narrative they want you to believe. These Masons are all together on this.
War stance right now. Just as... Apple and Google seem to be competing with iPhones and Android and collecting all the data on users' locations. What we've seen in this coronavirus is that as soon as the narrative changes, as soon as they create a new reality, they just say, well, now we need to work together for contact tracing. Yep. And we're going to take all of the iPhone data and all the Android data, and we're going to marry these data sets, and we're going to turn it over to the police. And so it's entirely reasonable to expect that China and Russia and the U.S. could, in the future, given some external crisis, maybe it's the blue beam alien invasion, who knows at this point what card they will pull. It doesn't really matter. All that matters is that it's entirely possible for these three mega systems that are being stood up right now to then be merged into a single global AI with total information awareness around the world. And that is the Ring of Mordor, right, that they're trying to build. I'm not sure who will get to wield it, but it doesn't really matter because it can only be used for the extermination of humanity.
I mean, yeah, there you go. And he doesn't understand who Satan is, Lucifer the Lightbearer, the adversary. And his goal is to wipe out the planet. And sadly, for those that have told Jesus no, or, you know what, I'm too busy. Jesus told a parable about that where, you know, the people were invited to the wedding supper. And they were all doing something else. No, I just got married. I got to deal with this. Oh, I just built a field. I mean, bought a field. I got to go maintain it, right? Like, there's all these other things that become more important than getting born again. And so if you don't want to be Christ's new creation, you're going to be cut off as an unbeliever, as a slave, into this type of world. And, you know, we were all told by Tim LaHaye and the Left Behind movies, horrible books, that, you know, just in a second, in a random moment, the Father would, you know, kind of come up with a plan, although, you know, everything was already determined before the foundation of the world, my Bible says. But anyhow, the Masonic Christian, Tim LaHaye, told everybody, and not just him, but he was the one that most popularized it to the masses, I think, and other Calvary chapels, other organizations and people all told us over and over and over and over and over, you get it? That the rapture would just be random. It would just happen one day in a moment. It could be now. It could be in 10 seconds, right? We talk about this a lot. But in all reality, what we're actually seeing happening as you see the day approaching Hebrews 10:25, God is giving you some time. God's showing you, is this the future you want? You better seriously think about getting into the new creation in Christ. And if you don't, then you're going to be left behind. He's the one that said it. Christ is the one that said it in Matthew. Let me go there. These are his words. I'm not anti-pre-trib. I am anti-random. It's not Revelation. We need to go to Matthew. Let me get that for you. He's the one that said this, that two men will be together in the field. One will be taken and the other left. And he continues on with a couple more examples. He begins that paragraph by talking about that day that we keep talking about, the day and hour no man knows. That's Feast of Trumpets by name. In Jew talk, wedding talk. But of that day and hour, no man knows. Feast of Trumpets. Not even the angels of heaven, but my Father only. It's their Jewish culture. The Father would say, go get your bride. But as the days of Noah were, so also will be the coming of the Son of Man. Noah was in the ark, safe. And when he got out, he was the new creation that repopulated the earth. Does that sound familiar to you at all? In typology, you are the new creation in Christ that steps out of the ark, and the ark is Christ. For as in the days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage. Did you know that in Zoom they're having marriages and stuff like that? That's still going on. Until the day that Noah entered the ark and did not know until the flood came and took them all away, so also will be the coming of the Son of Man. Then two men will be in the field. One will be taken and the other left. Two women will be grinding at the mill. One will be taken and the other left. Watch, therefore, for you do not know what hour the Lord is coming. And this has to do, we'll look at the Greek here in a minute, because the English is not getting that correct. I'm not saying the Bible is not correct. I'm saying your English translation is not correct. You have to look at what the Greek says. But know this, that if the master of the house had known what hour the thief would come, he would have watched and not allowed his house to be broken into. Therefore, you also be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. So let's go look at this word expect. Let me get that for you. Okay, so Matthew 24:42. Keep watch, therefore, for you do not know on what day, hold on, the Lord of you comes. They do the word order a little bit different in this culture than we do in ours. So you go to the words here, you know, therefore, you do not know. Okay, and it is this word right here, 1492. To know, remember, appreciate. It has to do with perception. It means that some people don't get it. Be aware, behold, consider, perceive. He's not saying you can't know. You would have Hebrews 10:25 fighting against the scripture. The scriptures don't fight against each other. They go together. They coincide. He's not saying you can't know. He's saying some of you don't know. That's a big difference between saying you can't know and some of you don't know. Well, why? Why is that? He's saying, how do you, I do. Be aware, behold, consider, perceive. And the usage is in relationship to the concepts of I know, I remember, I appreciate. Properly to see with the physical eyes, as it naturally bridges to the metaphorical sense of perceiving, getting it is how we'd say it today. Mentally seeing, this is akin to the expressions, I see what you mean. I see what you're saying. I comprehend it. God is saying that there are those that better keep watch because you do not comprehend the feasts of when he's coming, that he fulfills feasts. He says you don't comprehend it. Hey, could it possibly be that maybe Jesus, I don't know, being omnipotent God that can see all things, knew that a large faction of the Gentile church would teach you everything in the world other than the feasts? So that there would be a huge number of people that believe it's random. It could be any day. It could be in 10 seconds, 5 seconds. It could be now, now, now. What about now? That's not helpful. That's actually really stressful. Plus, it causes you to be almost so hyper-vigilant that you're not vigilant at all. Because the Mason Tom LaHaye and his terrible books and movies, as well as many others, taught you to not appreciate the fulfillment with surgical precision of the feast days, which is what my channel hammers on, because we care about the truth. Seeing that becomes knowing. Seeing that becomes knowing. There is a gateway to grasp spiritual truth, reality from the physical plane. I see what is happening around me. I understand that with regard to appreciating the coming day, the day and hour that no man knows, as a title for the feast. Not that I can't know. I appreciate the feast, is what he's saying here. This is the physical seeing sight, which should be the constant bridge to mental and spiritual seeing. Look at that comprehension. He's saying, watch, because some of you don't get it. He is not saying you can't know. He's saying, some of you don't know, don't get it. But because of brainwashing, I'm sorry, I'm just telling you the truth. Because of brainwashing, people have been doled out to the point where they don't think you can know. And then they ignore Hebrews 10:25 and the feasts and everything else. To perceive. So this is why we're watching. By seeing, learning, to perceive by the senses, perceive, notice, discern, discover, to see, pay attention, observe, to see about something, consider, inspect, examine, to look at, to behold, to experience, to have an interview with, to visit, to go to have seen. Well, there's other uses of it too. It signifies not to have seen, but to know. Well, when everything's said and done, it's both. You know because you're seeing, to know. It is well known, acknowledged, to know. I get knowledge of, I understand, I perceive, to be skilled in, to have regard for one, cherish, pay attention to. See? Oh, and anything having to do with opt is the eyes. It is a primary verb used only in certain past tenses, others being borrowed from the equivalent of these two words, optime and horato or something like that. I'm not exactly sure how to pronounce that properly, to see literally or figuratively, but implication in the perfect tense only, to know, to be aware. And the perfect tense is like, it's a done deal. It's going to happen. Be aware, behold, consider, have knowledge, look upon, perceive, see, be sure, tell, understand, wish. Let's look at this optimi, to appear. I appear, am seen, let myself be seen. Become seen, appear. Right, it's like the, as you get closer, it's coming into your view. It is coming into your understanding. You can perceive it. This is why he tells you to watch. He doesn't say watch for the day that you can't know. And you're just walking around in a circle, confused. He says watch because there will be people who don't perceive. They don't get it. And part and parcel of the whole watch, which I don't have time to get into a bunch more Greek words, but it has to do with the idea of being ready, which is another theme that he starts taking you through in Matthew 24 and 25. And the idea of being ready is not that you go get 400 pounds of dried beans that the government's just going to come and steal from you. That's not being ready. Being ready means rebirth. And understanding the pickup window. In the weird year where your government has gone completely tyrannical. As you see the day approaching and he fulfills feasts, be ready for your pickup, for your glorification. Now they also take you to this word. In the original language that your Greek manuscripts were written in, see how it doesn't say what the English is trying to force it to say? It doesn't say you can't know. It actually says that you can. Yes. It says, I see, I perceive, I attend to. I see, I look upon, I experience, I perceive, I discern, be aware. I don't know how to pronounce this. Hor-a-o? Hor-a-o? Properly now. See. Often with a metaphorical meaning. To see with the mind. Spiritually see. I perceive with inward spiritual perception. And then they go into a lot of the Greek grammar. Aortus form is discussed at 1492. See. The future tense and this middle passive form are discussed under this 3700 optimi C, which we already were there. Does any of this in the Greek communicate to you? You can't know. No, actually in the Greek, it tells you, you absolutely can. And it's on the day and hour that no man knows, which is the pickup date. So we're going to treat this next 150 days watching for the fulfillment of Feast of Trumpets, as if that is the pickup. Okay, well, what happens if he doesn't come? Then they're going to have a whole nother year of planning, which is scary. But nonetheless, we can only do what we can do, which is to watch for this next 150 days, especially as your government tells you in the clearest language possible, oh yeah, we totally have a space force now. We're totally going to hem you in. And there are vaccinations coming, and you will be getting them by winter. Well, winter follows fall, doesn't it? So the timeline is really starting to materialize, isn't it? Let me see. I want to go into one more thing and then we're going to quit. Now, don't get mad at me if you love the English that people transliterated for you and decided what they would turn your copy of your Bible into, because we're going to go to the pure translation of the manuscripts that have been put into English for us with Strong's. Thank you, Dr. Strong. Thank you so much. And here is what he says two verses later. Right, in relationship to the day and hour that no man knows. And then he's like, watch, 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 be ready, watch, watch, watch. There's going to be a division, one taken and one left. These are his words. Left Behind did not come up with this concept. Now, they told you it's random. He says, no, it's fulfilled on a feast day. Watch. Look at this. He says here in verse 44, he says, because of this, what we've already discussed, also you be ready. For in that day, you do not expect the hour the Son of Man comes. So, two things. Okay, let's go to ready, because a lot of people just parrot puke the ready word, right? And they never tell you what, define ready. What do you mean ready? And if you listen to some people, they would tell you that you need to go fill your house full of dried beans and tuna and whatever. Is that what Christ is saying? That you're all about ready to get it, and I really need you to go out and get a bunch of food that the government's just going to come and steal anyhow. Is that what he's saying? No. What does the word ready mean? Well, 2092. Okay, so het oimos. That's an adjective. This is for ready. This is when he says, be ready. Ready because prepared. Standing by. Standing by? Really? I should be standing by. Ready to meet the opportunity challenge at hand. Ready because the necessary preparations are done or are sure to happen as needed. What does that mean? You got born again. This is all about being born again. Even if you don't understand the rapture, if you don't understand the pre-trib, if you, for those who are truly born again, not everybody that calls himself a Christian really is. Even if you don't understand those things, if you're born again, you're going. This is all about being born again. This is all about being a son of God. All about being a son of God. And when you are ready, it is because you have been born again. You've been justified. You're in the middle of being sanctified, and you're going to be glorified. Jerusalem is going to give birth to her children, the heir, and you will get your new flesh and ascend where? To the throne with God. The Son, the head of the new humanity, along with you, the body, makes up one new mankind, are going to the glory to go meet the Father. That's what's going on. This is why this is all tied in with a wedding theme. For those who are ready, opportune, seasonable, at the point of being revealed, ready to hand, prepared, ready. See what I'm saying? Adjusted, ready, prepared, made, readiness to our hand. This means that people still have an opportunity between now and the Feast of Trumpets. If this is the year, and it looks like it is, we'll see the day approaching for your pickup. But you have to be born again before he comes. Revelation 10, he's got that list of the names in his hand. Okay, so that was the word ready, be born again. For in that day, You do not expect. Okay, well, what is expect then? Well, first off, no unbeliever is expecting him because they don't believe him. And then a lot of believers have been told so many different things by the culture that you don't know what end is up. You don't know what to believe anymore. 1380 will fill it in. It says, Doke Ao needs to have an opinion. It's saying that not that you can't know, but that some of you don't know because of every different various opinion. And right now on Facebook, which I'm staying away from, I know that there's people out there that are like, Pentecost, Pentecost, Pentecost. Pentecost has been fulfilled. In fact, it's kind of still in the midst of being fulfilled as people become born again. It has nothing to do with the wedding. It has nothing to do with the glorification. Nothing. Or, you know, the other things that people said. There is no rapture. Oh, really? Go tell the Bible that. Revelation 12:5. That's where the word rapture is used in the entire book of Revelation. The only place in that book where rapture is used is in relationship to Jerusalem giving birth to her glorified new creation. And she is not a real person. She's a covenant. Look at this. Properly suppose what seems to be forming an opinion, a personal judgment, an estimate. Suppose directly reflects the personal perspectives and values of the person making the subjective judgment call, i.e. showing what they esteem or not, as an individual. It is the root of dogma. Each cognate stresses the subjective mental estimation or opinion about a matter. He's not saying you can't know. He's saying some of you don't know because you hold every different opinion under God's green earth on when Christ is coming. And therefore, you need to watch the feasts. You need to watch for the day and hour that no man knows is the exact name of the Feast of Trumpets and so many other names. Rosh Hashanah, Yom HaKaseah, the Day of Concealment, Yom HaDin, the Day of Judgment, the Day of the Lord, Yom HaZikaron, the Day of Remembrance. These are all names for it. The day of the shouting for joy, the time of Jacob's trouble, the birthing pains, the opening of the gates, Isaiah 26, the Ha Kedushin, the Nesu, the wedding ceremony, the resurrection of the dead, the Rosh Chodesh, and there's 12 to 13 of those, but this is the feast where it's on a sliver moon. All the other feasts are on a full moon. This is why it's a day and hour no one knows. Because there's like a 2-day lag on a 1 to 2 day lag on when the moon reappears. When they see the sliver of the moon, bingo, it's the Feast of Trumpets. Okay, well now we have computers. We know exactly when the feast is gonna happen. The day of the awakening blast, the day of the gathering together, the episunagage, the assembly, the natzel, the rapture, Yom Adonai, the day of the Lord, the day of Christ. It's the start of the bridal week. This is all the names for it. The birthing pains of Messiah, the day of the opening of the books, the day of the thief in the night. It is the day when kings are crowned. Are the born again males and females going to be crowned on that day? Yes. Are we also going to be at Christ's coronation in heaven? Read Revelation 4 and 5. Yes. And on and on and on it goes. And Christ was born on the Feast of Trumpets, 9/11, 3 BC. We know this for a fact. It's not opinion. But they have worked really hard to keep these things out of your understanding. A prolonged verb to think by implication, to seem truthfully or uncertainly, uncertainly, to be accounted. Reputation, seem, good, suppose, think. He's not saying you can't know. He's saying there's people that don't know. This is why we go by the Greek manuscripts and Strong's Concordance. This is why we take in the Hebrew understanding of what's going on, because we're marrying a J. Jesus is a J, the King of the Jays. The admonition is to be awake, to watch, to pay attention, to be vigilant, alert. That's what we're trying to do on this channel, to show you what's happening in the world in alignment with what the Bible tells you is happening, looking at everything. And there's only so much we can pack into a video, which is why we do so many videos. He's literally telling you, literally, stay awake, figuratively, be vigilant, responsible, watchful. Get it. That's what he's trying to say. Get it. Understand what's going on. Give strict attention to, be cautious, be active, be watchful. Is this year a little different than any other year? Yeah. See how labor intensive it is to go into the Greek to waken, to rise up. You know, you can read the English, but it may not give you the full flavor of what the Greek is trying to communicate, that your manuscripts were written in, to arouse from sleep, to awaken. He's talking about you perceptionally getting it, to arouse from sleep or death. There's different ways that this can be used, and he's going to call the dead up. When is he going to call the dead up in Christ? On the Feast of Trumpets, on the day and hour no man knows, on the sliver new moon. It all goes together. It all goes together. This is why he has feasts. This is why the church, who are millionaires and household names, subdue this, so that you're not ready. He's saying that if you would have watched, if you would have got it, if you would have been prepared, if you would have been reborn again in relationship to this coming time, then your house wouldn't be broken into. There's two thieves coming, a good thief and these psychopaths, Mason thieves, who want your kids. This is not theory. This is happening. Be broken into 1358. I didn't intend to do such a long video, but my goodness, how are we going to fit this in 15 minutes? To dig through, to break into the house. I dig through, I break through. Well, they're doing that figuratively with their laws and their technology and their abuse of power. To penetrate, I can't even pronounce that. The act of a burglar will just say, I can't even pronounce that word. On account of, see, they're breaking through your constitution. They're breaking through, and Christ is going to come no matter what. And he has the power to call us up, and everything that is housing the Holy Spirit. And I think your children are sanctified and believers, but it's also a good idea to have your children repent and trust in Christ as well. But anyhow, Christ is coming, and everything that is housing the Holy Spirit, that is a new creation, that got justified and sanctified, you're going to get glorified. Done deal. But the bad guys are also breaking through, because your constitution and everything was an illusion. Your protection and safeties from the bad guys was an illusion. So properly across to their side, back and forth, to go all the way through, successfully across, thoroughly. Commonly used as a prefix to lend to the same idea, thoroughly, literally, successfully. See the copious layers of information that exist to help solidify your understanding that are not well represented if you just read the English and nothing else. I dig out, I excavate. To burrow into the ground. They're coming, and so is he. Hide that ark, hide the new creation, is what he wants you to do. That's why he's saying this. That's why he's telling you to be prepared. Be ready, because not everybody appreciates and understands that I fulfill feasts and that I'm coming and that you'll see the day approaching, that you'll see the preliminary setup that I warned you about. Who then is the faithful? faithful servant. And the wise, whom has set the master over the household of him to give them the food in due season. The faithful, wise person is the one that gives spiritual food to the hungry people in the midst of the time of destruction, food, nourishment, maintenance, giving good instruction, giving you the biblical wisdom, substance of instruction, nourishment, rations, food, meat, not just food you yum yum eat, you know, turkey sandwich, the spiritual food to feed your spirit man that should be alive if you're born again. He's literally telling you the wise and the faithful person is the one that gives you the truth. And in a world that absolutely hates the truth, it's quite a job. Look at that wise. The opposite of wise is fool, and in the Greek, that's moron. Practically wise, sensible, prudent, sensible. Look at this. Personal perspective, regulating outward behavior. Controls the bodily functions from the inside out, how we size things up, reflecting our personal visceral opinions, what we consider savvy, smart. These are the roots to our personal perspective, our internal outlook, which regulates our definition of being shrewd. It reflects the personal mindset, the insight. There's another cousin root word of it. Ding, ding, ding. To have understanding, to think, to direct the mind, to seek for, to observe, I care for. The midriff or the diaphragm, the parts around the heart, properly regulate, moderate from within as an internal, I-N-N-E-R, internal perspective, insight, shows itself in corresponding outward behavior. Especially equates to personal opinion fleshing itself out in action that aligns with what Christ has told you, all of it, up to and including the feasts. The idea is difficult to translate into English because it combines the visceral and cognitive aspects of thinking. To have understanding, to be wise, to think, to feel, to have an opinion of oneself, think or feel. But see, this is an opinion that is formed and forged in the words, true to their meaning of Christ, from the original language. So yeah, I just encourage you to check out the human wedding customs. And remember, God isn't a human. The Father is not a human. Jesus Christ did become a human. But they're omniscient. Jesus is the God-man. There is a hidden day. That hidden day lands on the feast that we've been talking about. What is the role of the high priest? The role of the high priest is to intercede to God on behalf of the people. Only the Father knows the day and hour to confirm the new moon. When the new moon is confirmed, the trumpet is blown. Jesus is God in human form. Notice this language is also consistent with the ancient wedding customs of the Jays. The father sends the son to go get his bride. Only the father knows the day or hour of the wedding. It's not that Jesus doesn't have access to that. It's part of a custom. It would fall to the father to say, okay, go. It's an authority thing. It's a courteous thing. It's part of their wedding banter. Yom Teruah, that's another name, the day of blowing. Is the new moon holiday, that Rosh Chodesh, that sliver moon. Rosh Hashanah, the head of the new year, is the only Jewish holiday that falls on the first day of the month, that Tishri 1. And that is actually October 17th, according to Stellarium that I've been in a couple times. The Feast of Trumpets is the only new moon holiday, but of that day and hour no man knows, it is a hidden day. Investigate, think about it. It's Yom HaKaseah. It's the whole reason why they read 60 times Psalm 27. So anyhow, it's a figure of speech that is to connect you with this feast. So yeah, Psalm 27:5 for good reason, uses this word right here, 6845. And just like Moses' mom hid him for 3 days, so is Christ going to hide you, conceal you. That's why you're going to the wedding when you get glorified, put on your immortal flesh. Hiding his servants, treasure up a thing to thyself for his own keeping, for thine own keeping. Reserve penalty, blessings. God has treasured up their heart from understanding. I mean, there's lots of ways that it can be used. This is how this word will be used, which is what this right column is all about. I've hidden his words in my heart. He's going to hide us. Same concept. He is going to hoard, reserve, deny. A primitive root to hide. This is the kaseya, the yom kaseya. By covering over, by implication, to hoard or reserve. Figuratively, to deny. Deny what? Deny punishment. Why? Because you're under the lamb's blood. Specifically, favorably, to protect, to lurk, esteem, hide, hidden one, self, lay up, lurk, beset, privily, keep secret, secret place, conceal. See, he shall hide me in his pavilion. It's all there. When? Feast of Trumpets. And they repeat it. For he shall hide me in his pavilion in the time of trouble. He shall hide me in the secret place of his tabernacle upon a rock. Christ is the rock. Do you see any trouble forming for which you need to be hidden? If you got born again, bad, evil, bad, disagreeable, bad, unpleasant, giving pain, unhappiness, misery, evil days of trial and hardship. Oh, you mean like the time of Jacob's trouble? Evil, displeasing, bad, bad, sad, unhappy, bad, ethically, of persons, of thoughts, deeds, actions, calamity, evil, distress, adversity, evil, injury, wrong, ethical. And then you see that fourth horseman coming. You know what that fourth horseman wants to do. Okay, thank you very much if you hung with me through the whole thing. I appreciate it.